Bugatti, Lamborghini, Ferrari, McLaren, Mercedes are all supercars that seem to be widely known and most often talked about. But do you know there are quite a handful of other insane supercars with amazing features that ever existed but have managed to escape massive publicity? If you'll just stay a little while, you'll get to learn about some of them. In this video, we're going to show you 8 supercars and hypercars that you probably didn't know existed. So let's dive right in. Number 8. Beck LM800. The Beck LM800 is a Swiss supercar that took its name from its manufacturer René Beck and Le Mans cars that inspired its design. Its appearance on this list is as a result of its rarity, confirmed by the fact that only a prototype has ever been produced. The production of the LM800 was first announced to the world in January 2007 by Orca Engineering and Composites GmbH, a small Swiss manufacturer specialized in the production of top-class super sports cars with an operation based near Bern, Switzerland. The company, founded in 2003, got its name from René Beck, who, when he was a schoolboy, spent every free minute he got fiddling with homemade sports cars. He had a motto, and that was, "We start at the point where others have already given up." The LM800 had a lightweight construction, which was a result of the use of the most varied low-density materials, such as aluminium, magnesium, titanium, as well as the latest plastic and composite materials. It also got a basic construction similar to a Formula One racing car, with a central monocoque made of composite materials that protect the driver and provide the necessary rigidity. The engine is a 4.2-litre twin-turbocharged V8 with a 7-speed semi-sequential RWD-marked gearbox that ensures power transmission to the wheels via a limited-slip differential. The V8 engine, attributed to Beck's own design, pumps out 650 horsepower and 663 pounds-feet of torque. It has an estimated maximum speed of 217 miles per hour at the rate of 0 to 62 miles per hour, attainable in 3 seconds flat. The LM800 supercar weighs an average of 900 kilograms or 1,984 pounds with a fuel tank capacity of 120 liters, 31.7 US gallons. Priced at 750,000 Swiss francs, an estimated £308,000, it probably is no question why only a prototype was ever produced. Number 7. Isdera Commendatore 112i. The Isdera Commendatore 112i was named in honor of Enzo Ferrari, who was awarded the title Commendatore Due, which means Knight Commander in the Italian language. The car was made to showcase new styling and technology to the automobile world. The concept was conceived and developed by the German company Isdera, a low-volume automobile manufacturer with an assembly plant in Leonberg, Germany. It was introduced at the 1993 Frankfurt Motor Show, but the company's lack of financial capacity led it into bankruptcy, and that means only one prototype of the 112i was completed. With a compact and sleek aerodynamic bodywork, the 112i was seen as a successor to the Imperator 108i. The team got an inspiration for the sleek design from the famous Group C race cars. The services of some Mercedes-Benz engineers and technicians was engaged in the development of the car, with approval from the company, of course. The 112i had a 6-speed manual transmission, transferring power to the rear wheels, a feature it shared with the Porsche 911 Turbo. Also, it had a hand-built bodywork on a tubular steel space frame chassis and 18-inch gold BBS alloy wheels wrapped in tires. The large side intakes helped cool the engine, that was generating a maximum power output of 408 horsepower and 428 pounds per feet of torque. In performance, the car had an estimated acceleration rate of 62 miles per hour, attained in 4.7 seconds with a top speed of 212 miles per hour. Aside weighing an estimated 3,256 pounds, the 112i supercar also measured 182 by 73.5 by 40.6 inches in dimension. The car was updated and renamed to Silver Arrow by a Swiss businessman after the company was bought over by Swiss investors, who updated it with new wings and showed it at the 1999 Frankfurt Motor Show. However, it was recently bought back and returned to its 1993 concept car form by a reborn Isdera. The development of the car reportedly cost the German company a total of 4 million euros, which partly contributed to its bankruptcy alongside the economic recession of the time. Number 6. Touchec Renovatio T500. The Tušek Renovatio T500 is an unusual supercar, assembled in Slovakia by Tušek Supercars in 2012. While the Renovatio could be one of those cars that's easy to dismiss, it offers something truly unusual in its class and is more predictable and approachable than most cars with their engine amidships. It's particularly suited for track use, with its consumables expected to wear out or overheat less quickly than an alternative. With a carbon fiber and carbon composites, the supercar is estimated to weigh 2,498 pounds. That makes it get along pretty nicely. It takes just 3.7 seconds to sprint from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour, clocking a top speed of 310 kilometers an hour in the process. The Renovatio makes a modest 444 horsepower as it's powered with a 4.2-liter Audi RS4 V8 engine and a rear-wheel drive by a 6-speed manual gearbox, with the engine in between a slight rearward waste distribution and a hydraulically assisted power steering and servo-assisted carbon ceramic brakes. It makes very audible noise because of the lack of attached soundproofing system. Though the Renovatio has its tyres made of a particularly high-performing compound, with both pairs hanging gamely, a bit of body movement is still experienced under braking and cornering, but body control is always very tight. The manufacturer planned to produce only 30 before moving on to the next project with a unit price of $450,000, or £375,000 after conversion. Number 5. SSC Ultimate Aero XT. The SSC Ultimate Aero XT is a derivative of the SSC Ultimate Aero series of sports cars assembled by SSC North America, formerly known as Shelby Supercars. The XT was launched in 2013 to mark the end of the Aero series. Only 5 of them were produced. While it most certainly wasn't a regular type of sports car you'd want to see, it's more accurately described as a hypercar. The aero in the name indicated how the car was designed to be as aerodynamic as possible. The SSC Ultimate Aero XT was built with a twin-turbocharged aluminium V8 torque block, producing 1,300 horsepower and 1,004 pounds per feet of torque. The engine is replenished with a compression of 8,625 to 1 at 9,200 rpm. The Aero XT uses 91-octane premium fuel. The hypercar is fitted with a 7-speed SMG paddle-shifted gearbox with a triple-disc carbon clutch. With 44% of its 2,800-pound weight distributed towards the front, it's classified as a mid-engine rear-wheel drive car with a carbon-fiber body constructed with aluminium crash structures. The hypercar is equally equipped to take speedometer reading up to 300 miles per hour. The XT could accelerate at the rate of 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 2.6 seconds and has an estimated speed of 273 miles per hour. The pricing for the XT was set at around $1.3 million at production. Number 4. Low-Tech Sirius. The Low-Tech Sirius was built as a sports car, built by German automobile company Low-Tech. The owner, Kurt Lotterschmidt, who was both the manufacturer and owner, regarded as a dream. It was designed for high speed and could reach 400 kilometers an hour, theoretically, though that number was limited by the tires. The power output was dependent on a turbocharging variable. The engine generated 1,000 horsepower at 6,300 and 1,000 Nm at 3,400 at the 0.85 bar boost. Both values reach 1,300, with an increase of 1.2 bar. It took 3 years to construct this concept car, and the Low-Tech team believed they could sell a road-going version of the car, which would take 1 year to complete by their estimation. But till date, no road-going version has either been built or sold. Number 3. Venza Sarte. When a prototype of the Venza Sarte was unveiled in 2013 by Prince Albert II of Monaco at the Top Marks Auto Show in Monaco, the car barely gave off a hint of what was to be expected of it. However, it would later clinch the Most Sensational Supercar 2013 award in September 2013. Sarte, the brainchild of Dutch entrepreneur Robert Cobben, was deliberately built not to be everyone's car. As a completely new supercar, it was to be a road car that's purely to drive and still not compromised by electronic interference. Cobben was inspired to design the Sarte by the 1980s iconic 24 Hours of Le Mans race cars. The car has all the panels on the inside made with full carbon fiber. The Sarte is powered by a supercharged 6.3-litre V8 engine driven by a 6-speed manual transmission gearbox with torsion-limited slip differential that produces 622 horsepower and 618 lb-ft of torque. The car has a top speed of 210 miles per hour and the capacity to accelerate from 0 to 62 miles per hour in 3.6 seconds. Weighing 1,390 kilograms, it has a 45% front to 55% rear weight distribution. The Sarte has a pricing of €270,882, excluding VAT and local taxes. Number 2. Arash AF10. The Arash AF10 supercar that debuted at the 2016 Geneva Motor Show was a production of Arash Motor Company, a supercar and hypercar manufacturer based in Newmarket, Suffolk, England. The AF10 is their attempt at a hypercar. Considering its name, it was touted more of a hypercar than a supercar. By design, the Arash AF10 was built with four electric motors and one supercharged 6.2-litre V8 engine. The four electric motors each turn out 295 horsepower and 199 lb-ft of torque, with the V8 engine giving 900 horsepower and 886 lb-ft of torque, totaling an output of 2,080 horsepower and 1,682 lb-ft of torque. In addition, the hypercar has an acceleration rate of 0 to 60 miles per hour in 2.8 seconds, made possible by the aforementioned power, 6-speed automatic transmission, and an incredibly lightweight carbon fiber tub. It also has an estimated top speed of over 200 miles per hour. Its price is set at £1.1 million, which is approximately $1.55 million. Before moving on to number one, if you think you learned something today, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also turn on the notification so you can get notified when we release other videos in this series and make it easy for you to follow up. And now to the most insane of them all, steps in the number one, Covini C6W. The Covini C6W is an unusual six-wheeled rocket supercar built by Covini Engineering, an Italian car manufacturer. The project, which was at the back burner for the most of 30 years, was regarded as an on-again, off-again project, but was eventually shown in prototype form in 2004, with a plan to go into limited and on-demand production of 6 to 8 cars per year. It was built as an Italian 2-seat, 2-door sports coupe with a removable roof section. The $400,000 car features 4 front wheels and 2 rear wheels, and a rear 4.2-litre V8 engine that produces over 500 horsepower and has a top speed of 186 miles per hour. The engine is paired with the usual 6-speed manual transmission or 6-speed automated single-clutch shift, comparable to those used in Ferraris and Lamborghinis in the early 2000s. The introduction of the 2 extra wheels at the front was designed to not only increase turning bite and general stability, but also to improve braking power and economy with 4 front brakes. While the front brakes may be smaller than if the automobile only had 2 front wheels, it meant a larger area, which means higher stopping force and less braking heat. We'll also not forget to mention that adding 6 wheels gives the automobile more convenience. Well, at least that was what we knew at the time the prototype was produced. And today, there's just one C6W, and it has never been produced officially. Crazy. If you have not watched the other videos in this series yet, what are you even doing here? You're missing out on some real stuff, man. They'll be linked down below in the description, and also right here. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.